What's going on, everyone? Today, we are exploring Alaska, the last frontier and the largest state in the United States. Outside of the big towns like Anchorage or Fairbanks, Alaska lives up to its nickname of the last frontier. I first visited Alaska 7 years ago with my wife, and we have traveled back to the state every year. Alaska is a fisherman's paradise, and we got hooked from the very first cast, both figuratively and literally. And yes, we did have to pull the hook out of my back. Nothing beats the crisp summer air in Alaska, until the frying pan-sized mosquitoes come out, of course. Or the sight of a bear in the campgrounds, and trust me, they are no Yogi Bear kind of friendly bear. For those that love the outdoors, Alaska is heaven. The frontier has so many places to see, activities to do, and memories to make in the outdoors. So before your travels lead you to Alaska, you need to watch my top 10 outdoor activities in Alaska. Number 10. Gold panning. In the late 19th century, the Klondike Gold Rush hit Alaska, with thousands of prospectors coming to Alaska to search for vast riches of gold. With harsh winters, cutting through permafrost, and fights over land disputes, succeeding in the Gold Rush was tough. Although, if you built a pop-up bar and gambling joint for all the prospectors, you had it made. Today, just a handful of large-scale mines in Alaska still dig for gold. Most small-scale gold mining operations are family-run placer gold mining efforts, like the ones you see on Gold Rush on the History Channel. But you can stake your claim and try some gold panning and try to get rich. At places like Gold Daughters outside of Fairbanks, you can learn how to gold pan like a prospector and find some gold to take home, and finish your day at the saloon. Just don't brag about how much gold you found. Number 9. Watch the summer solstice. Alaskans love their summer solstice. With so much sunlight in the day, you can fish, work on house projects, and enjoy the outdoors for 20 plus hours a day. Cities like Anchorage have Downtown Day with a huge celebration downtown with music, activities for the kids, and people stay up way too late past their bedtimes. And as you venture north, some cities see the sun set at midnight and come right back up into the sky starting at 12:01. It's a sight to see. Although, it's not as bad as cities in Alaska that get 67 days of darkness in a row in the winter. That would give a whole new meaning to day fishing. The last time I tried to stay up and follow the sun in Alaska, then it dawned on me. Number 8. Float the river. Alaska has over 12,000 rivers in the state, which means it would take you close to 33 years to float every river in Alaska. Now, my definition of a float down the river is a day trip where fishing is involved. But with so many rivers in Alaska, you can float down for days, camping along the banks, and finding hiking trails in the frontier where no human has had access with a car. One of my favorite parts of a river float is seeing all the wildlife along the way. It's not uncommon to see bears or moose hanging out by the banks of any river in Alaska, especially during salmon season. But just remember to wear your waterproof gear and bring a life jacket. Safety first. Number 7. Sightseeing. When you visit the last frontier, you get to be a part of the frontier. It's not uncommon to pull over to the side of the road and see bears, moose, whales, and an occasional caribou. Within the city of Anchorage, you can drive down the neighborhood road and see a moose hanging out in someone's front yard, playing with the sprinkler on the lawn, of course. With access via boat or plane, visitors have options to go deep into the wilderness to sightsee for bears, whales, and occasionally orcas out in the bays. Some sightseeing tours get up close within feet of the bears on the sandy beaches. I love bears, but I'd rather see them on TV, and I'd avoid the guide that tells you to bear with him and inch closer and closer to the bears. That's how accidents happen. Number 6. Big game hunting. Within Alaska's vast terrain, big game animals roam the last frontier, especially moose, which outnumber the total residents in the state of Alaska. First settlers, and even residents today, rely on big game such as mountain sheep, moose, caribou, and bear to keep their families fed throughout the winter. In outlying and off-the-grid cities and residencies, access and the ability to hunt for wild game can be the only access to meat before the winter snow and ice storm. If you're from out of state, find a guide to take you on a hunt. There's too many stories of people hunting and getting lost. Stay safe out there, and definitely watch out for moose when driving. Running into a moose with a vehicle is the number one cause of death in the state. Drive safely, everybody. Number 5, fishing for halibut. Alaska is the halibut state, and Homer is the halibut capital of the world. Most of the halibut caught, processed, and shipped to grocery stores comes from Homer, Alaska, in South Central Alaska. In my opinion, it's one of the best tasting fish out there and even more fun to catch. Although the first time I ever halibut fished, I went on a charter with my wife and father-in-law. The first place we stopped, I mistakenly volunteered to jig for halibut while everyone else put their rods in the holders. Pulling 5 pounds of lead up and down at 300 feet from the bottom of the ocean for 45 minutes straight, probably the most exhausting thing I've ever done. But I did catch the biggest halibut of the day. There's nothing like catching groceries and knowing where your food came from. Unless you catch crap. Number 4. Hiking. Alaska boasts some of the best hiking trails and mountains in the United States. When the winter snow melts and the spring flowers start to bloom, Alaska becomes a hiker's paradise. The most popular of places being Denali National Park, with majestic views, camping, and trails to hike for days. It's also the highest mountain peak in North America. But don't overlook places like Exit Glacier, where you can literally get within arm's length of the glacier, and Crow Pass that falls part of the Iditarod Trail. But one thing about hiking in Alaska you need to do, bring bear spray. It's the last frontier. Bears are everywhere. Make sure that spray is in your hiking bear necessities. Number 3, road tripping in an RV. One of the best ways to see Alaska, rent an RV and travel across the state. Traveling within Alaska can be tough. Between boating, small planes, and very few major roads, getting around the state can be a challenge. But Alaska offers many places for visitors to camp across the state, making renting an RV an easy way to road trip. And during the summertime, the RV is a must for a family road trip vacation. But a word of caution, always throw your trash and food away at your campsite. You don't want to encounter a hungry bear. Of all the spots to RV camp in Alaska, camping near river or creekside camping with fishing access are my favorites. But camping near Denali National Park might be number one. The views of the mountain range and access to hiking trails provides views you have to see in person. And just remember before you leave the campsite that all members of the party are in the RV. Don't ask me how I know. Number 2. Kayak to a glacier. Only in Alaska can you grab a kayak, paddle out in a bay, and go touch a glacier. Since the ice ages, places around the world have had glaciers, but none more amazing to see in person than in Alaska. Some glaciers even have tunnels for kayakers to paddle under and be within the glacier itself. It amazes me how cool glaciers are, especially when the sun shines on the frozen water, and how crisp and clear the water is in taste. It's no wonder breweries in Alaska use glacier water to brew their beer. Just don't get in a drinking competition with the local. They don't have glacier water in jail. And number 1, salmon fishing. The very first time I ever visited Alaska, I introduced my wife to salmon fishing from the bank. And that's when she got hooked. In every part of Alaska, you can find some of the most remote and beautiful locations in the world. But you can also fish elbow to elbow on big rivers like the Kenai in the summer when the sockeye salmon are running. Most of the salmon you see at the store probably came from Alaska, either in the seafood section or in the can. Ugh. Salmon fishing to me is peaceful. Just you, the river, and the fish. It's a chance to get away from the hustle and bustle, enjoy the outdoors, and fish with family, friends, or in my case, my best friend in the world, my wife. And as the kids say, the tug is the drug, and I want more. Thanks for watching my top 10 outdoor activities in Alaska. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. Alaska is an outdoor playground with lots to offer for anyone that loves the outdoors, whether you're visiting Alaska or thinking about moving there. And until next time, everybody, the outdoors is a gift. Share it with others.